G'day there, everyone. Welcome to Temporal Paradox One. My name's Derek from moviestudiozen.com. If you're listening to this tutorial right now, most likely I've directed you to watch it. And this tutorial is all about Horpage users. I don't know how you pronounce that name, but I'll call it Horpage. And Horpage unit is one of these things. No, I didn't want that ad to come up. Personal video recorders for recording gameplay. And the most common problem I get asked all the time is people record something with their unit, they then plonk the video into Vegas, and either Vegas Movie Studio or Vegas Pro, and they get a problem where only one quarter of the video displays in the preview window. Now, the reason why that's occurring is because of the codec that you recorded your video in. Okay? Because the Horpage unit records to MP4, M2TS, and an AVCHD format. So if you go to the Features tab on the actual Horpage page, it shows you here recording formats. There are three H.264 formats you can choose from when recording a video. .TS is a generic transport stream compatible with many digital video players. .TS is actually what is one of the formats that's used for creating Blu-ray discs. Then you have the .M2TS, which is compatible with Sony PlayStation and Vegas Movie Studio and Vegas Pro. And then there's the .MP4, which is compatible with Xbox 360. So this is the mistake that people are falling for, recording to the .MP4 format, which is understandable, but if you read the instructions on the website, you'll see that that particular codec is only suitable for playback on an Xbox. And you know, the reason behind this is because I know video codecs and formats can be very confusing, but the problem is that a .MP4s are not all the same. An MP4 is actually a container for many possible video codecs. And many video codecs are very specific. They will only work in particular pieces of software, particular devices. So that's why some of them don't work in Vegas. It's not Vegas's fault. No program on earth can possibly play back every codec that's in usage. The reason being is that codecs, quite often specialized codecs, have a licensing fee attached to them. Now, if people like Sony Creative Software put in the capability of every codec in the universe being playable in Vegas Movie Studio, well, the price of the software would go through the roof. Okay, so that's why you need to use one of these more standardized codecs. So .M2TS is the one that I recommend. You can try TS if you like. The other thing you have to remember is that these files you're creating with your HD PVR, they're high definition. They're very large files, highly compressed. So this is another reason why when you plonk them into Vegas, you can quite often get problems with lag. And it's only because highly compressed large HD files need to be decompressed in real time, which is a really big struggle. So one of the things you can do to improve your playback just while you're editing is reduce your screen down to good or preview mode and reduce it to say quarter or half. And remember, there's another little setting in here where if you right click on the preview screen, you can have the video scaled or you can have it unscaled. The problem with scaling sometimes is when it's scaled, it can make everything look a little bit blurry. So if you get that blurriness effect, turn it off and just set your frame size automatically. But please use preview or good, but don't use best while you're actually editing and want everything to run really quickly. Obviously, the best solution of all you can do is to make sure you have a really powerful graphics card and CPU installed, and that will help things dramatically. So that was a bit of a mouthful. Hope that makes sense. Hope that clears things up a little bit for you guys. Just remember, the universe isn't perfect. The more technology that is invented, the more complicated it gets. And everything has its, you know, you've just got to work these things out. So be patient, stick with it, and you'll get there in the end. Thanks for watching, guys. Catch you next time.